Hi, I'm Jennifer Hollick with the World War II Research and Writing Center, and I wanted to give you just a few tips if you're planning to travel in Europe anytime the rest of this year or in 2020 to retrace the steps of your military ancestor. We've had a lot of new clients show up in the last several months. Many of them want to travel in Europe, and a few of them have said, you know, I'm getting ready to go in about a month and a half, 2 months, and what can you do for me in that time? And sometimes we are able to structure the research if we can get some of the records. Some of the records are out of our control as far as archivists have to give access. Other things are within our control and we can find them pretty quick. But that's not the norm for most military researchers to be able to drop everything and do rush jobs so quickly. I'm lucky that with the people that I work with, we're able to move some things around from time to time when that does come up. But if you are thinking about taking a trip or you've got one planned and you think, do I want to know more? Do I want to travel in their footsteps? Do I want to make sure that I have the information correct and not just what I've heard through the family stories, but I know that these are the actual footsteps he took? Start early. And usually, in a non-rush situation, if you were going to go overseas and you needed to get the research done and maybe get in touch with a tour guide, which we can help you with, we need at least 2 or 3 months to get through the whole research process. Usually it takes a little bit longer just because of the records access and the number of clients that we have and the different projects that we're working with. But it's almost always possible to shift some things around and help you out. But if you're thinking about traveling, one of the things that you definitely need to do is make sure you have your service member's full name, date of birth, service number, if you have a discharge paper or an IDPF, that death file that shows, you know, when they died, what units they were in, maybe where they're buried, then that is very helpful to get started and will make the research process go a little faster. If you have family letters, especially with the envelopes that usually have a unit for somebody, very important for Army and Army Air Forces if the service file burned. Those are also clues that can help you move the research forward a little bit faster. Most of what you need is not going to be found online except in some rare cases. So you do either have to go to St. Louis at the National Personal Records Center and do the research yourself, or you can work with us and we can get the records in usually a pretty quick turnaround. Like I said, the ones we have control over. If you are thinking of hiring a military researcher, do not send in Form 180 to St. Louis and then go hire a researcher, because your request is going to tie up that service file or the death file, which makes it a delay and we won't have access to it. Sometimes we have to ask clients to call St. Louis and cancel their request. And once they do that, which causes them some hassle, then we are able to get those files within like 7 to 10 days, sometimes a little faster, depending on how things are shaking out down there. But it's really important, and it doesn't really help the process if you send in Form 180 and then turn around within even a few weeks and hire a researcher, because there will be that lag and we'll have trouble getting that file. So either choose to send it in and see if you get something, or hire a researcher or go there yourself, because you'll get much better results. When you work with a researcher like my firm, we are able to pull records that St. Louis isn't going to send you. So if the service file burned and you've waited 2 to 4 or 6 months to get that letter that says, sorry, it burned, here's the final payroll, but oh, it doesn't have a unit on it, you've wasted a lot of time when you could have been doing some research. So we are able to help guide you through the free phone consultation that we offer and help you figure out what you need. We create a research plan and we go get those records and create the report, help you plan your trip if you need it, help connect you with tour guides overseas if you need that also, so that you get more of the boots on the ground experience and take the trip of a lifetime. So if you're interested in learning more, we are scheduling free phone consultations. And all you have to do is connect with us through the World War II Research and Writing Center website or our Facebook page, or email me at info@wwiirwc.com, and we'll get that set up. Whether I'm in Chicago or I'm in Europe, we can set up phone calls from anywhere. and we are ready to help you take the journey of a lifetime. And I can tell you from personal experience traveling in my soldier's footsteps and that of some of my clients that it will change your life. And I think everybody should take that trip if they're able to, because it will change so much and it will heal a lot of the past and provide a lot of answers and closure for you and your family. So if you're ready to start that journey, even just doing the research, because maybe you're still a few years off from an actual trip, we can still get you the foundation that you need to plan that trip and make your plans. Love to talk to you. Please contact us if you'd like to know more.